One of the members on my website asked me how to create something that looks like this. So this is some sort of stepped topography, and I thought it would be interesting to find a way to convert regular topography into something that looks more like this. And that's exactly what I'm going to be showing you in today's video. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and I have this old project, and I think it's just interesting complex topography, and let's use this for our demonstration. Now, this is a topo surface, and I'm using Revit 2024, so I'm actually going to be converting this from a topo surface into a topo solid just by selecting it and then going here to modify topography, generate topo solid. It's going to give me some basic settings. I'm just going to set that up, and this is what we get. So now here we have the topo solid. Okay, so now what do we do? What's the next step? So what you wanna do in order to get these contour lines to turn into individual slabs is you basically want to first make sure that you have enough contour lines. So if you select your topo solid and go into edit type, you will see that here we have the contour display. And if I go into edit here, we can set up the interval. So here I can leave the interval. I'm just going to set the kind of everything at 50. I can even turn this one off, hit apply, okay, apply, okay. So now we have that interval set at 50. So at every 50 centimeters or half a meter, I'm going to have a slab. Now, what I want to do for those slabs is I actually want to use these contour lines and just use big lines. So if I go here to the site plan, for example, just like this, and then if we go here to architecture and go to floor, for example, and if I use big lines and try to pick one of these lines, it's simply not going to work. It is going to recognize the exterior boundary, but if I try to select any of the individual contour lines, it's not going to work. And to do this manually, it would just take a long time. So what I figured out as a solution, and let me just escape out of here, is to actually export this to CAD. So I'm actually just going to select this house and get rid of it. And now I can go here to file, export, and then go to CAD formats, and let's just export to DWG. I'm not really going to care about all of the dimensions. I'm just going to hit next, and then let's save it on my desktop. I'm just going to call this one my site plan. Okay, click OK. And now that's exported. So now when I bring it back in, if I go here to insert, link CAD, and then if I just find that site plan, here we go. And just make sure that here current view only is checked off. This is the only thing that can kind of mess everything up. So I'm just going to leave that checked off. And usually because we have just exported this from Revit, all of these settings are going to kind of, in terms of the positioning, it's all going to work out. So when I click OK, now this should be loaded back in. So let's go here to the 3D view, and you can see we are starting to see some double lines. And if I select this, okay, this is the topo solid. Let's see, it can be a bit hard to find. Okay, so here's the site plans, the lines. So if I select the topo solid and perhaps hide that, and this one we can get rid of, here we can see just a CAD file with simple lines. But what's great about these lines is if I now go to architecture and go to floor and use pick lines, I can actually pick each one individually. Unfortunately, the chain option doesn't work no matter how many times I hit the tab key, so that's a little bit annoying, but that's okay, we can work with this. So I'm just going to exit out of this, then I'm going to bring back my, let's go here to reveal hidden elements, and I'm just going to unhide this element. So I just want to bring this back in so I can see kind of the bottom where I want to start from. Because we have this depression here, I want to start with that. So what I'm going to do is go to one of the elevations. So let's open up the south elevation, and then let's add an additional level down here at the bottom of that topo solid. So just like this. So we have that level 3, and we're just going to start from level 3. And finally, we need a floor. You can use floors, you can use roofs, you can use topo solids if you want. I'm just going to go with floors for this one. And then let's go into the site plan. And for this floor, I'm just going to, let's start with the generic 300 millimeter, go into edit type, and then duplicate, and call this one 500 millimeter. And now if I click OK, and then for the structure, increase this to 50 centimeters. Okay, apply, okay. And now I can get started. So I can just use pick lines, and I'm just going to give it one overall boundary like this. And you can see how fast this is going just because I'm using those pick lines. And then I can go back here and I can see, okay, so this is where that depression is happening. So I can go here to the site plan and I can just kind of use these lines here. But first, I'm just going to do one blank one for the bottom and then hit finish. Okay, go to the 3D view. Or south elevation. Okay, so that's here. I actually want to bring it down to level 3, just like that. And then let's give it a 50 centimeter offset so it goes from there up. Okay, so once we're here, now let's create a new one. So I'm just going to go to copy, paste, align to the same place, and then just increase this to 100. Just like that. Then I'm just going to go back to the site plan, and here I'm just going to go to edit boundary, and I can just carve this one out, for example. So I think it should be this one. Let's see. So it is a little bit of clicking. It is some manual labor, but it does work really quick. So now when I look at it, and let me again select this topography, and let's just hide it temporarily. Okay, so we still need to have one additional one. So I'm just going to go here to copy, paste, align to the same place, and let's just drop this one to 0. So that one is below. So when I select this one and go into edit boundary, I can just use this for the smallest contour line. So that should be for this one, and just hit finish. So now when we go to the 3D view, it's starting to look like this. So now we can move on to the next one, which is going to be this one here. So for that, I would just select the top one, go to copy, paste, align to the same place, and then set this to 150. That's going to bring it up a little bit. Go to edit boundary, go to the site plan, and then here I can use the tab key to select the whole chain, delete that, and then start picking these lines here. And it's basically a simple process of just clicking on lines. You have to go back and forth to the 3D view just so you can see what's going on. So this is where we are. And then we can always turn off temporary height isolate just to see where we are. Okay, so we have another set of lines here. So let's hide this again. And then for the next set of lines, again, I'm just going to copy this one, paste, align to the same place, and now set this to 200. It's going to bring it up, edit boundary, and you basically just continue doing this. So in this case, I'm deleting this one here, and then I'm moving to the next one. So let's see here. Okay, so here we go. That's this one. Now at this point, it might start being hard to select some of these lines. And the reason for that is, if I just hit escape, is because we have that topo solid overlapping. So we can just hide it in this particular view. And then we can continue doing our work. So if I just go back to the 3D view, edit boundary, delete this one, and then move to the next one. And now you can see it's a lot easier for me to select these lines. So it's just a matter of doing all of these. So I'm just going to continue doing that. And with a little bit of back and forth, we get to something that looks like this. As you can see, in this case, the house is back. And also, this one was set to 25 centimeters or 250 millimeters for the contour lines, and then basically the floors are, we have 250 millimeter floors used, and it's just going to give you a much nicer and cleaner look, and I really like the way that this turned out. So there you go. If this is something that you're interested in, this is the approach that I would use. Now, if you want to get access to this Revit project file, as well as all of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.